Hello all, welcome to part 14 of Docker Made Easy tutorial. In this session, I'm going to practically show you the live execution of Selenium automation scripts on Docker containers using our day-to-day browsers. So let's get started. To get started, I'll start Google searching for these three terms. First term is Selenium. Second term is Docker. Third term is GitHub. Just Google search for Selenium, Docker, GitHub, and in the Google search results, you'll get this link from github.com for Docker Selenium. Click on that link. You'll be taken to this page. Now you have to scroll until you find a section on this page known as debugging section. Let's scroll. Keep scrolling until you find the debugging section. I have to scroll a lot. So where is the debugging section? Here is the debugging section, guys. In the previous video, I've shown you how to watch the live execution of the Selenium automation scripts on Docker container using the software known as VNC client software. But now we are not going to install any software for watching the live execution of the automation scripts on Docker containers. Instead, we are going to use our day-to-day browsers to watch live execution of the automation scripts on Docker containers. So let's get started here. Here we have to run this command, guys. Before I start running this command, let me download the Docker image for this standalone Chrome. Okay. So how to download? For that, guys, I'll open the command prompt, and in the command prompt, first I will type the command Docker images. You see, there are no existing Docker images that are already downloaded in my machine. Zero Docker images. Similarly, I will type Docker PS. This will give the list of the containers that are currently running. As you can see, there are no Docker containers that are currently running in my machine. So no Docker images, no Docker containers. Simply say CLS, it will clear the screen. Now, what I have to do here is I have to run the command for downloading that Selenium standalone Chrome Docker image. How to download that? For that, guys, go to this hub.docker.com. Go to this website, hub.docker.com, and here search for Selenium/standalone. When you search for that, in the search results, you'll get this kind of results like Selenium standalone hyphen Chrome from Selenium. This is the thing that we want, right? This is the Docker image we want. So to download this Docker image, I need to click on this. And here I have the command docker pull Selenium/standalone-chrome. Copy this, go back to the command prompt, right click, it will be pasted. The command will be pasted, say colon and say latest. That's it, okay? So this will download the latest Docker image for Selenium standalone Chrome. Let's wait for this Docker image to get downloaded successfully, okay? So let's wait. I will pause and resume the video once the download is completed. As you can see here, the Docker image for Selenium standalone Chrome has been successfully downloaded. So we can cross check again. So here I'll say CLS and say Docker space images. You can see this Docker image now present in my machine, right? The downloaded Docker image for the Selenium standalone Chrome now exists in my machine. That's first thing. Now, after we have this Docker image for this Selenium standalone Chrome, what I want to do next is I want to go to this page again. And here, under this debugging section of this page, under this using your browser, no VNC client is needed section, if you go there, you can see this command, right? Docker run -d and all those stuff. Okay, copy this. Till colon, you can copy, guys. Remaining part you can ignore. Copy till here. Okay, now go to the command prompt and right click. So it's not copied properly. I'll copy it again. Come back here and say right click. Now it got copied and pasted properly. So this is the command, guys, for running this whatever the Docker image we created, right? Using the Docker image, we are going to create the Docker container and run it. Okay, this is the single command. And here the main important thing is that this port number 7900 is there, right? This 7900 is important, guys. This part, this portion is very important. Okay, just remember this. We are running on the port number. This particular Docker container, using this Docker image, we are creating and running on this particular port number, that is 7900. Okay, that is very important, guys. At the end, guys, after the colon, just type latest. Okay, just type latest and press enter. So you see, the container has started running. Now I'll say Docker PS. You can see the containers that are currently running. You see only one container is running that belongs to this Docker image standalone Chrome, Selenium standalone Chrome Docker image related container is currently running. While this is running, and it's running at which port number? The 7900 port number it is running, okay? It's running at this port number. When it is running, guys, when it is running at this port number, now you can type this URL, okay? Which port number? 7900, right? So you have to use this URL, okay? So in your, in any of your browser, guys, either in Chrome or Firefox or anywhere, just open the browser and say HTTP, say colon, double slash, localhost, colon, what was the number, guys? 7900, guys. After colon, give 7900. That's it. And just press enter. You'll get this kind of page saying no VNC. Without using any VNC client kind of software, now directly from the browser, we are going to connect to the Docker containers. We can watch what's happening inside the Docker containers from the browser itself. That's what. Here I need to click on the connect, and it will ask for the password, guys. The default password for this kind of containers is secret, guys. You see, here it is mentioned on the page, secret. Just give the same password, secret password. Password itself is secret. And say send credentials. The moment you say send credentials, you will get connected to the Docker container. From the browser, you are able to see what's happening on the Docker container. This is the Docker container, okay, which is currently running in my machine. Fine. Now, let me run some automation scripts, okay, Selenium automation scripts, so that you can watch what's happening here on the Docker container, okay? For that, I'll open this Eclipse ID, create a new project. I'll search for Maven here. Select this Maven project, click on next, click on next again. Here I'll type Maven archetype hyphen quick start. Let's wait for a while for these archetypes to be available here. Once they are available, select this last one, 1.4 from Apache Maven, Maven archetypes quick start. Click on next and give some project name, say demo project one, something like this, okay? DPO. Just give some random group IDs and package names here. This project name is important anyhow. Click on finish. The Maven project with that given name will be created here. Demo project one got created. Let's wait until this loads. Now expand this project and go to the SRC test Java directly. And under this package, we got a default file, Java file. Delete that. It's not required. Now under the package, create a new class. Say demo class. You can give any name anyhow. Select this public static void main. We are auto-generating the main method inside the demo class. Now here, let's write the code. Let's write the Selenium automation code here. So how to write? First line will be, we need to create an object for the desired capabilities class. Desired capabilities, DC is equal to new. Desired capabilities. Okay, desired capabilities, DC is equal to new, desired capabilities. For the mouse, you cannot import this desired capabilities because this is a predefined class of Selenium, guys. So how to get this class imported? For that, open this pom.xml file. Go to this dependency stacks inside the pom.xml file. Remove this default JUnit one. Save this once. And now go to the another website, that is MVN repository. And search for Selenium Java here. Selenium Java. Once you search, you will get this link. Click on that and take the latest version, whatever that is available as per your date. Click on that link. You'll get this, copy this, guys, and go back to the Eclipse and in the pom.xml file, paste it. Whatever you copied, you just paste the dependency tags of the Selenium Java here. This is what we have to do. Now save this. This jar files for this added dependency will be automatically downloaded and configured in this project. Now close this. Hover the mouse now on the desired capabilities. If you're not getting, just give it some more time and again hover. This time you got import desired capabilities from Selenium. Click on that. Now here say DC dot set browser name. Okay. This object reference dot set browser name. And in the double quotes, give Chrome. Okay. Chrome browser. Now say web driver. Driver is equal to new. We need to create an object for the remote web driver class, guys. Remote web driver. Instead of creating an object for the classes like Chrome driver class and all those stuff, we have to create an object for the remote web driver class. This kind of scripts only will run on the Docker containers. That's why we have to create an object for the remote web driver only. Okay. Docker container is a remote container, right? That's why you have to create an object for the remote web driver instead of Chrome driver or whatever the drivers. For the mouse, import this web driver interface from Selenium and hover the mouse and import this remote web driver also from Selenium. Put a comma here. says this remote web driver constructor, put a comma here and give the second argument as this GC. And the first argument you have to give that as new URL, circular brackets, hold the mouse on this URL and import this URL from java.net and provide the double quotes here. And here type http://localhost:4444. Okay, this is the URL you have to give. Now hold the mouse and say add throws declaration. Ignore the exception. Now here, so let's write some automation script here using this driver object, driver.get command. I want to open a sample application URL here. Let's say I'll open this Internet Heroku application, guys. This application I want to navigate to or open using the Selenium automation script. After that, what I want to do is I want to get the title of this page printed in the output console of this Eclipse ID. For that, system.out.println, I'll write. And here I'll say driver.getTitle, nothing much. Okay, it will print the title of this page here in the output. After that, I'll simply close the browser. I'll quit the browser. Now save this, guys. The sample Selenium automation script is now ready. And if you run this script, it should run on the Docker container and we should be able to watch it here. Okay, we should be able to watch it here. So from the browser, we connected to the Docker container and we can see what's happening inside the Docker container now. Using the browser itself, we can watch. Now, when you run this script, you should see what's happening inside the Docker container. It should open the Chrome browser. It should open the Chrome browser. It should open this application URL in the Chrome browser. Then it should get the title and print in the output and then close the browser. Okay, that's what should happen. Now run this, right click run as Java application. So it started. It will be very fast, guys. So let's see. Sometimes it will be fast and all. So better, let's focus on this container while the script is running in the background. Let's see if any Chrome browser launches here. You see, the Chrome browser has launched here. Chrome is being controlled, okay? And now you see application has been opened and then it would have already collected the title of the page and printed in the output console here. And then it has closed the browser. So we have watched it live, right? The execution or running of the automation scripts on Docker container, you are able to watch live by connecting to the day-to-day used browsers like Chrome browser or whatever the browser. You just have to give this URL in the browser and we can connect to the Docker container and see all the things that are happening on the container. So this is what, guys, I wanted to explain as part of this session. Okay. Yeah, you have this, whatever the script I have used here, that script you can get from here. Okay. From here you can see, and you have visually seen the automation scripts getting executed on the containers. So that's it, guys. Thank you. Bye.